Okay, so this will be our next example. The problem states that we are required to obtain your I using delta to I and y to delta. Okay? So for delta to I, meaning we need to find your resistances or your resistors that are connected in delta and convert that to I, and hopefully that in doing so during the process of conversion that will be resolved into either series or parallel. So if we try to look for y or for delta, 3, 5 and 6 are in excuse me, delta. Okay? Or 4, 5 and 7 are also in delta. So if we make use of 3, 5 and 6 to be in delta, so this will be our terminals. Okay? We will try to resolve your 3, 5 and 6 into y. Yan. Ito pang isa. And the other one is this. Okay, supposing that this is your A, B, and C. Okay, let us try to find what is A, B, and C using delta to Y transformation. So, we try to recall the rule. A, product of the two adjacent legs. The adjacent legs will be 3 and 6. So, this is 3 times 6 divided by the sum of the delta connected legs, which is 3 plus 5 plus 6. Okay? For letter B, the adjacent legs of B is 3 and 5 divided by the sum 3 plus 5 plus 6. In a similar manner, your C is, okay, adjacent legs is 5 and 6 divided by the sum, that is 3 plus 5 plus 6. Okay, we will try to compute. The value of this is 14. Okay, so 18 divided by 14 is 1.286. Then 15 divided by 14, 1.071. And the last is 30 divided by 14, that is 2.143 ohms. So if we will try to redraw your figure, will look like this. We have used your 3 ohms, 5 ohms, and 6 ohms. Meaning, tanggalin mo na yung 3, 5, and 6, palitan mo ng A, B, and C. O yan. Palitan mo lang siya ng delta. So this is 60 volts, 2 ohms. We have here your I. Then C. Then 7. Your A is 1.286. B is 1.071. And C is 2.143. This is 7 and 4 ohms. Okay? It is now possible to obtain the total resistance. Because the total resistance is just equivalent to the parallel combination of 4 and 1.071 in series together with 7 and 2.143 in series. Okay, so this is 4 plus 1.071 plus 7 plus 2.143 plus 2. So the total resistance is what? Okay, let us try to compute. That is 3.261 ohms. So remember that our total resistance is 3.261 ohms. This will now give you a value of I, which is 60 divided by 3.261 divided by 60. The value is 18.394 amperes. Okay, it is also possible to solve the same problem, this time using Y to delta. Okay, okay, next let us also try to solve the same problem using Y to delta transformation. Okay, next, how many resistors in Y can you see? Dalawa o isa? Okay, isa lang ito, no? The resistors in Y is 6, 5, and 7. If you will consider 3, 5, and 4 being in Y, where will you be getting the third leg of 3 and 4 to make up for the second Y connected legs? So, isa lang. Okay? So, we need to transform your Y connected legs into delta. Okay? Transforming, this is the equivalent resistance. Ito yung equivalent resistance. Ito yung equivalent resistance. Okay? So, supposing that this resistance is represented by X, by Y, and by Z. Okay? Remembering the rules that we have a while ago, X is equivalent to, okay, sum of the products taken two at a time, that is 5 times 6 plus 6 times 7 plus 7 times 5 divided by the opposite leg. We are using your leg 6 and 5, so the third leg is 7. For Y, the numerator is the same, so we will just have to copy that. Copy lang, no? 6 times 7 plus 7 times 5 divided by the opposite leg. For Y, the opposite leg is 5, since we have used your 6 and 7. So this is 5. And the third one, that is your Z, same numerator, that is 5 times 6 plus 6 times 7 plus 7 times 5 divided by the opposite leg. We have used your legs 5 and 7. The opposite leg is 6. Computing 30 plus 42 plus 35, that is 107, that is 107. Okay, divided by 7, that is 15.286. and for Y, 107 divided by 5, 21.4. And the last, 107 divided by 6, 17.833. So if we will now try to redraw our figure, replacing the Y connected resistors by its equivalent, okay, here is how it will look like. this is your I, 3, 4, okay, this is your X, we have there your Z, then your Y. Okay, it will now be very easy for us to recognize how are these resistors related. 3 and X are in parallel, 4 and Z are in parallel, the two parallel groups are in series, together they are in parallel with Y. Okay, next. So what is the parallel combination of 3 and X as well as 4 and Z? 3 in parallel with X, 15.286, that is 2.507. 4 in parallel with Z, 3.267. Okay, and if we will try to redraw our figure once more, you will see that your circuit will actually look like this. This is 2.507, 3.267, 60, 2 ohms, that is your I. Okay, then we have there your Y, that is 21.4 ohms. So we can obtain now your total resistance, because 2.507 and this one is in series, this series group is in parallel with 21.4. Okay, so let us try to compute. Total resistance is 6.547 ohms. So the value of I is 60 divided by 6.547 ohms. So your I is 9.164 ohms. Okay, the result that you can obtain by using Y to delta and delta to Y should be the same. If ever that we have an error, it might be due to the rounding of figures. What I want here to illustrate and show to you is the means of obtaining the answer using delta to Y and Y to delta. Okay.